Hey guys, we're bringing you another Divergent Paths. We're doing Panicked Flight with the Child.
Yep.
I brought my Ten Thunders, Casey brought his Arcanists, as usual. And we'll show you guys the table and we'll go in more detail about the mission. See you there.
Generating the schemes. So we got a 12 of masks and a 5 of masks. Or tomes. Sorry, new deck.
Here's our scheme pool. We got Breakthrough, Always Line in the Sand. We've got Protect Territory, Frame for Murder, and Vendetta. I'll show you guys. Here's my crew. I brought Lucas McCabe with Glowing Saber, Promises, and Badge of Speed. Luna, 4 Guildhounds, 10 Thunder Brother, a Gyrogumo, and a Yasunori. I don't have the card, so I'm just using Ototo as a proxy, and I have the book, so we'll know exactly what Yasunori does, and I got a really cool new model to count as Yasunori.
All right, once again, I'm bringing Marcus. I'm starting to... I like all the different things he can bring because we'll get to. So he's bringing Miranda as usual. Now, this is one I've got. Misstep, or it counts as Howard Langston, trying out the new Blade and Claw upgrade. The Jackalope and 2 Wild Boars, the main one of the big reasons I decided on Marcus. And then, speaking of new models, I'm bringing Hans. Only I have this excellent model from Hassle-Free Miniatures, and Hans has Imbued Energies. And speaking of other things, we've been talking about Scatter Terrain. I got that painted up. You'll see it on the table. Here's a few little close-up views of it. This one here has sort of broken up glass as soul stones. All right.
And also a new piece of terrain that I painted up.
So. Oh, yeah. The GW Obelisk. Pretty nice for, like, Malifaux ruins.
Yeah. Doing the other pieces soon, so we'll see those shortly.
And that's the child there.
Yeah.
Proxy as
we're using the effigy. He's childlike.
Okay. So now we're flipping for picking sides.
Yep. Deployment. Okay. So it's my choice.
Would you like to pick, or would you like me to deploy first?
I want you to deploy first.
Deploy first. Okay.
All right. So we're going to be playing the week 1 and 2 with the child, Panicked Flight. So at the center, we have a child marker. And we're going to have 2 Witchling Stalkers on either side. Today, they're being played by 2 empty bases, plus Nurtz Harshbane and Dr. Grimwell. And they're going to move... Each turn, they're going to take 2 walk actions to get as close to the child as possible. As soon as they get in base contact, the child is removed from play. Now, we score victory points by either killing the Witchling Stalkers, that scores 1 victory point for each stalker you kill, and for having the child within 6 inches of your deployment zone. And it's locked into corner deployment for this scenario. So you're trying to get the child into your deployment zone while killing the Witchling Stalkers. The maximum you can earn is 8 points, so if you manage to score max points for everything, the child and the stalkers, you can get 8, but that's probably not going to happen. It's probably going to be both of us killing some of the stalkers and fighting over who gets the child. So yeah, this is going to be an interesting battle. Oh, and one other thing. So how do we get the child to within 6 inches of our deployment zone? Well,
summon Michael Jackson.
Oh, jeez. Well, in reality, a model within 2 inches may interact to push the child marker 4 inches in any direction. Now, I've already seen a few battle reports of people talking about killing the child to deny the enemy victory points. Now, we've talked, and reading over the rules, me and Steve both agree that the child is referred to as a marker.
So we can't shoot
it. Right, so it's not a model with wounds, so we're agreeing that we can't do damage to it. And it's just a marker. So, yeah, we've clarified all of that. And
so we're going to go over our deployments. So I chose this corner of the board. I deployed the Thunder Brother, the 3 Hounds, a Jargumo in the building, 2 Hounds right here, Yasunori, and McCabe. We, right in the corners right there, there's 2 Witchling Stalkers. There's 2 over there. Casey in the shadows, hit one of his boars there and right here. And then there's his Hans model right there, Miranda, Marcus, and the Jackalope. And right behind the building right there is Misstep. Here's my hand. Now we will transition into Deathmaster Casey's hand. Haven't heard that name in a while, right, Case?
Yeah, I'm fine.
All right, and there's my turn 1 hand. Gotta love Arcane Reservoir.
Position of these two right here, and then right across from me.
They went around to get as close as possible.
All right. That will go into Casey, or my turn.
Yep, you got the first action.
Activating Luna right here, and Luna's going to move a little back right to here.
What, are you afraid of sniper fire?
Yeah, I know. It's almost as if you have a sniper in your field.
And it's almost like Luna's important.
Yeah, I know, right? For
scoring. All right, yeah. So that's your first. I'm activating the Jackalope. So the first thing is he is going to attempt to use Leap.
All right.
I need a 5 of masks. So 1, I'm not going to cheat that. So he just gets his...
Walk
4.
Oh, only 4? Wow.
Yeah. Charge 7, walk 4. So jeez. It's very important that you leap
so
or
when
charge.
So when he gets that sprint on, is it just like he's that tired?
Well, you know, he's just, it's a rabbit. He's just hopping. Walking along on his little feet. As long as he gets to, like, leap and is full, yeah.
All right. Hoppity hop. That the Witching Stalkers could walk second. Twice, so they went from here to about there.
Okay. Activating Tenth Thunder Brother. He's going to dance in the heavens.
Dance for me.
Engagements 4. He's going to double walk.
All right.
He's going to walk. He's walk a 5. Right? Yes, walk a 5.
Walka walka.
Boop. And he's going to walk right to.
All right. I'm going to activate Hanzina.
Hanzina?
Whatever. I have to figure
that's
out a better name.
That's one they should do a miss of. A Miss Hans? Or Miss Hanna?
Well, I already have a... Well, that's already... We already have Johanna.
Yeah.
I guess Hanna would be Hans.
Yeah.
Anyways, so I'm going to take the focus action.
Okay.
That increases my range to like 30...
Redonkulous, okay.
36 inches.
Yep. You're going to fire.
So I can reach the Jirigumo.
You're going to fire the Jirigumo? Okay. Yep. And
so focus. Focus.
Mm-hmm.
Then I'm going to use reference the field guide
mm-hmm.
and discard a crow.
Okay.
And now I'm taking a shot at Jirigumo. Now, unlike most sniper rifles, his does not have a positive built in.
So it's just, you're just doing the positive.
The positive from the focus in this
yep.
case. Now,
and there's no cover.
You're more than an inch right from cover. Yeah. So positive flip.
The Jirigumo got a...
I'm at a 10.
I'm at 11.
So you're at 11 with the 6.
Yes.
And so that's defense 5.
Yes.
Whatever. 12. So 6, 7, 8.
11 to your 18?
18. And I currently have the kneecap trigger. After damaging, the target model may discard a card or gain slow. Or, hold on. No, I may discard a card to give you slow.
Okay. So that would be... I'm going to cheat in a 10 of crows to make it a negative.
Right. So we're at negative...
To a straight, back to a
straight,
negative.
Back to a negative, right.
Because of
okay, so negative twist. All right, so that's 2 damage and slow.
2 damage and slow. Okay.
I'm also going to reveal that I have Vendetta against
Jirigumo. Okay.
With Hans.
So that's 2 damage to my Jirigumo.
Yep.
Okay. Damage on Jirigumo.
And he's got the slow condition.
He has
slow. Oh, I need to discard a card for that.
He ditches a card for slow. And now my turn.
Yes, you're up.
Okay. I'm going to activate McCabe. For the first thing, McCabe is going to attempt to cast Black Flash. On this hound right here.
The hound in the front.
Exactly what I needed.
That's the ram.
He gains reactivate. And then I'm going to take this with him.
Mm-hmm.
And I need a 5 of anything, I believe. I need a 4 of anything. I'm cheating a 4. Exactly what I needed. And I'm gonna do the movement afterwards. I'm gonna cast it again.
Okay, so Tomes is the trigger, right?
Yeah.
So 4 of Tomes to trigger.
Yeah, to do it again.
Second casting. All right, it's cast.
Off. All right, I'm gonna give him a glowing
saber. Well, actually, it's important on your first push that he's still in line of sight.
Okay.
Yes, 6 inches in line of sight.
4.
And right with that big ass base,
yeah.
Can see,
and then you can do it again.
All right, and so
that casts
Right, so pushed. Then the second push.
Yeah. Right up to there.
And actually, it's also important because you don't know if the second will succeed, so you have to push him without knowing.
Oh, you're right.
But just for future, especially if we are ever in tournament play.
And then McCabe is going to dirtle around here.
Okay. Is he, I'm just curious. Or
he's walk 7.
Walk 7. Yeah, yeah. So he's got plenty, even if he's not unimpeded. Yeah, he can get there.
Let's just play it safe. We don't put him back a little more. There you go.
Yep. All right. So, right. One action for that, two walks, and the zero. And he has both the Glowing Saber and the Badge of Speed, correct?
Yes.
All right. And, well?
Yeah, no, just one.
Okay. I'm going to activate this boar.
All right.
He's going to charge this Witchling Stalker. He's got 8 inches of charge movement. Put him about there. Yeah, and that's easily within 1 inch of that Stalker. Actually, I'm going to put him a little further back so he's engaging both of them.
Okay.
Or actually, no. His other, sorry.
No worries. So Casey charged, and he's going to go right over to this direction.
Yes. Okay. I just need to check one ability.
Sure. Pig is done.
So that's his final position, and now he's going to attack that base.
This Witching Stalker.
Yep.
All right, flipping for his defense.
Yep.
Okay, I got double check.
Alright, so you're not going to cheat, so it hits. That's a difference of 5, so negative flip, negative twist.
Yep.
Alright, so 2 damage to that Witchling Stalker.
Alright. We'll put dice next to it afterwards.
Yeah. Second attack against him.
Yep.
Ready?
Pshaw.
So I have 10 showing with the Stampede trigger, and I must declare triggers if able.
Defense 4, right? Defense 4.
On the Stalker is 5.
5.
And my total is a 10.
Cheat to a 13.
All right. So you cheat it to just miss. Let's see. I will cheat to tie with the Stampede trigger.
Okay. Can you charge a different target?
I will charge a different target. Sure. Okay. So first I'm at tied, and then so 3 cards.
Yes.
So first I have to damage. I do have to damage for that trigger, I believe. Wait. After damaging, yes. So I'm at 1, 2, 3.
Red Joker.
Red Joker. So that's going to be 8 damage.
So kills it.
Kills that Stalker. Now, I ping 1.
Mm-hmm. And then burning 1.
Actually, maybe...
Casey's not...
So I'm not using Eat My Fill.
Yep.
I take 1 damage from my trigger and 1 damage from the... Witchling Stalker exploding?
Yes.
So I've got 2 damage and burning 1. Now I've got an 8-inch charge, which is going to bring me into base contact with the 10 Thunder Brother. Yep. I will charge him that way. And we'll remove this guy. Alright. Here is my attacks against him.
Okay. Defense 6.
Okay.
9.
Melee of 5, so I'm at 16.
That's you to a 12.
16 to 12. Okay, so negative flip.
Yep.
No trigger showing. Now it's my potentially to cheat, but I will not cheat. So negative flip, 1, 2. That's low, 2 damage.
So 2 damage on the Thunder Brother. Okay.
He's got 6 wounds?
Yes.
All right, so second attack.
Second attack. 11. Oh, all those high cards. What's your total?
Okay. 5, 6, 17.
17.
And so, I can't take this trigger twice. So I will not.
Could cheat it up to a 12.
Okay.
So negative flip for damage.
Yes. So negative flip. Now my potential to cheat. But it's a 12. I'd need a 13 to make it a straight flip. Which. Yeah, no. Okay, so 1 negative flip, 2 cards, 1, 2. So 2 more damage.
2 more. So 4 damage to him.
All right. And that ends the pig.
Okay. Activating this out. He's going to... He has a walk of 7 because of Luton. So moving 6 straight to here. And then he has 1 more inch right to there.
Okay.
And he's going to drop a ski marker.
All right.
He's done.
I'm going to activate Miranda.
there?
She is going to use her imbued energies to gain fast. He's going to walk 6.
Mm-hmm.
And she's going to... she is up to 6. But she's going to be a little further back, so she's just within 2 of the child. And for her third AP, she's going to interact with the child.
Okay.
To push it 4 inches.
All right. Okay.
She is done.
And she is done. So
actually, this other hound is going to walk 6 right to there. And it's going to drop a scheme marker.
Alrighty.
And be done.
All right.
Going to activate Marcus.
Okay.
He is going to, for his, I believe this is Trail of the Gods, he's going to give himself +3 walk.
Okay.
Not discarding any cards for extra. So he's got 8 inches. We'll start with 2.
Mm-hmm.
He's got 6-inch walk.
Okay.
Now he is just shy of this guy. However, let's see, his only 0 actions is Drazi's Chant, which I don't actually want to use on anything. So what he is going to do is he is going to cast Alpha on Miranda as a 2 action. So flip my card, need an 8 of masks, not of masks, I will cheat in for the masks. So Marcus, he is done, so when his activation ends, Miranda immediately activates.
Okay.
She's going to use a 1 interact to push the child.
Okay.
4 inches. Then she will walk. She's got a walk of 6. She'll walk to here, and she'll use her 0 action.
Turn into a beast.
Marcus, and then Miranda is removed.
And done.
Yep.
All right.
Activate this out. It's going to move 7. 4, 6, plus an inch more right to there. And then it's going to move another 6, 7, right to about to there. About right to here. That's done.
All
right. Activating that boar right there?
Activating this boar. He's already engaged, so... And just to double check, he is within 1.
Yep.
Okay.
So first attack?
Yep. First attack.
Fourteen.
5, 6, 7. So not gonna cheat. Second attack.
Second attack. Boop. 14 again.
18 with the stampede trigger.
Not cheating.
14. What was it?
14.
14 to 18 for negative flip.
Yep.
Alright, so 2 damage to that stalker. So, alright, so with this guy as the proxy, I can't end with this as a legal charge.
Mm-hmm.
So after damaging, suffers 1 damage, must charge the closest if not engaged.
So you
charge
would still...
may be made while engaged. This model may only declare this trigger once per action. So, I mean, it says...
Suffer 1 damage.
Yeah, it seems like that's 2 separate... Because it doesn't, it's not dependent.
Yeah.
It's not if you make the charge.
So you would take 1 damage.
I take 1 damage, even though I'm not able to make the charge.
Yep. 1 damage on the boar. And
so 1 damage on the other boar.
Does he have to attack the same target then right now?
He already used his 2 charges.
Okay.
So there is no legal charge, so he doesn't charge.
So just 1 more attack?
No, that was both. The first miss.
Oh, you're right. You're right. Yeah, so.
So that's it.
He's done.
Yep.
Done. So, activating the sound. He's going to drop a scheme.
All right, first scheme marker. Double check.
Have to be within 4.
Yeah, at least 4 away.
Then he's going to nimble walk 6. He has enough movement to be right there. Right to there. Mm-hmm. And then he's going to drop another scheme marker.
All right, a lot of scheme markers. Which might have to be
adjusted. Adjustment. There you go.
Yeah, that one's easily out.
Yeah, there you go.
All right, so we've got a trifecta of scheme markers going.
That was a nimble walk.
Yep.
And then he's going...
Oh, nimble in 2 schemes, right?
Oh, you're right, you're right. So he's done.
So that ends his activation.
All right. Casey's activating a misstep.
Nope.
Oh, the blessed.
Blessed. So the Blessed is going to start by attempting to leap.
Okay.
So succeeds. I need any eight.
All right.
Blessed is going to, is up to 7 inches. So up to that far.
Okay.
Actually, that's exactly where she needs to be.
All right.
For her one action, the Blessed is just going to stand there.
All right, and she's done?
Yep.
Okay.
Akvan Jargumo, he's going to walk 5 to the end right here, and then another 5 diagonally through here.
All right, double walk to get to there.
And he is done. Ace is activating Misstep.
Yep. All right, so Misstep is going to start with her new fancy zero action, Blade and Claw.
Yep.
So this is the first time we're showing this on the channel, finally. So, first I have to cast it. I need a 7 of anything.
Okay.
So that's currently not cast. I will use a 9.
Okay.
So, all right, I start with target a friendly non-master non-peon beast.
Yep.
Blessed of December within range 8. So they're just within 8. I place a scheme marker in base contact.
Mm-hmm.
And actually, yeah, that'll be pretty good. Then, the place scheme marker over the target. Then place the target in base contact with target friendly non-master non-peon construct with an 8 in line of sight of this model. So targeting myself, since mm-hmm. it's a tactical action. Blessed is placed in base contact.
Yep.
And then...
she's placed in contact with the scheme.
Finally, place the friendly construct in base contact with the scheme marker placed by this action, and then discard the scheme marker. This action may only be taken... This action may not be taken on the first turn.
Oh. Okay.
So,
we'll end that right now.
So, never mind. You can possibly include that to make.
Yeah.
But will you probably.
For future reference, Blade and Claw cannot be used first turn.
All right.
That's why it's a new upgrade.
Yes, that's the first time I'm trying to use it.
Yeah.
So instead, Misstep will resort to her.
Pitter patter of little.
Mechanical feet. Nimble walk 5.
Yep. Then another walk.
Another walk of 5 to get. Within 2, and 1 interact to push
4.
4.
Good. And Dunzo.
And can't score turn 1, but that does put him just within 6 inches of my deployment.
All right.
Anything else, Nori? He's going to walk 6. God damn, that one's heavy. Could walk another 6.
Ooh.
All right.
That's not done.
Is he gonna do any zeros?
Oh yeah, I'll do a 0. Why the fuck not?
He's got 2 of them potentially.
Yeah.
Nothing's worth on the attack, but he does have his stack the deck potentially.
Yeah, let's see. I'm going to do these Great fools. Sage. I need at least a 6.
So 6 of cast and Red Joker.
That's
all right.
A bullshit reason for a Red Joker. so I'm going to the top 3 cards in my fate deck and return them in any order.
Yep. So you get to look and see what's coming up for Mr. Hounde. Boom, 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 boom.
Okay. I'll keep it as
All right. Without me looking, do you want to show the camera?
Oh.
You can look at the top 3. I'll look away. Tell me when you're...
There you go.
All right. So that was Great Sage, and you're done?
Yeah, activating this hound. He's going to Nimble Walk 6.
Yeah, that's what I would have done. Yeah. Something like that.
Drop another scheme. I think that's enough out of range.
Yeah, double check to make sure. Yeah, that's
good. Alright, and so that's Nimble Walk. Then he's going to walk again.
Alright. Run like a bitch!
And drop another scheme marker.
Wait, that's 4 AP, Steve.
No. Nimble walk?
2 walks and a scheme. So that's 3.
A nimble walk, drop a scheme. Oh, you're right.
Right, and then you walk to there.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, so that's where you want to end, right there.
Actually, I'll end him.
Oh, okay.
Where he was. There you go.
Okay, so basically not going to go anywhere with the last. Got it. Makes sense.
Here's my current hand.
All right, and here's the turn 2 hand for me. Initiative flip for turn 2. Seize the day. 13 showing.
Mm.
That's my answer to that.
Okay, and you're not stoning?
Not stoning.
All right, I'm going to take the first turn. I just need to figure out what I'm doing with it.
So if he gets in base contact.
All right, so yes, Witchling Stalker, walk of four. So he's heading this way as fast as possible.
So four.
Yeah.
Another four.
So that gets him there. He's still a little ways from the child. Now over here is where it gets a lot more interesting. Can I see the widget?
Yeah.
So this guy is pretty easy. Starts with his walk of four. He's got
another walk of four.
Four more to get as close as possible. However, this guy, I have the opportunity to make a disengaging strike. Mm-hmm. We've measured that he can't quite reach the child, but that will also potentially put him in a weird spot for my boar. I will attempt a disengaging strike.
Okay.
So, melee 5 to defense 5. And there's the red joker. So, he has a second walk action.
Okay.
I will still attempt to disengage.
17.
Do you want to cheat? Or actually, oh, no, first. I'm cheating first. I'm not going to cheat. Okay. Would you like to cheat?
He's just right. Going to walk.
Oh. So, yeah, he gets his 4 inches. Puts him about there.
Yeah.
And so he's done. And
right, activating misstep.
Mm-hmm.
Now that is not turn one, she's going to use Blade and Claw, targeting this boar just to double check 8 inches. Yep, easily in. So casting Blade and Claw. Okay, easily cast.
Goes off. Scheme marker.
So we place the scheme marker next to the beast.
Yes.
Then, let me make sure that's where I want it, because, yeah, I can go there to engage both of them. If I put it, yeah, there. Now the beast is put in base contact with the construct.
Mm-hmm.
The construct is moved into base with the scheme marker.
Okay.
Yes, that is the final placement. So that was a zero action. Now misstep is going to use
Flurry.
No, Flurry has to target the same model. So it's not really worth it to Flurry. I'm going to target the wounded one with an attack.
Sure.
But baby. Hitting with a 20. Not even a red joker can stop that. Their defense, that'd be 19.
Yeah, you're right. Let go.
Okay, so, sorry, what was the total on yours? 20, they're 5, they're 12. 20 to 12 is a straight flip.
Actually.
Yeah, let's go ahead.
I'm going to cheat in a 3.
All right, make it a positive flip. Fishing for that black joker. So, 5 damage. Finishes this one off. Actually, the funny thing.
Explosive demise?
Explosive demise gets both of us.
Yep.
So it takes one on him, and one on Missy Steps. Come on. Oh, and I almost forgot burning on this boar. So he goes down to 3. Misstep takes 1 burning. He's 1 damage and 1 burning. That's a dead. Misstep is going to use her second AP to attack the one that's still standing.
Alright. 14. Defense 5? 16.
16. Alright. Misstep misses.
All right.
So I have 1 nimble AP, which Misstep will use to go over here, staying in
engaged.
Engagement is 2 on both of us. So okay. Moving out to over there.
Okay. Now my turn.
And yeah, Misstep's done. I'm not going to chain anybody.
Okay.
I'm going to activate Yasunori. I'm going to burn Recall Train first.
Mm-hmm.
And we pre-measured this, so I'm going to
charging misstep.
Misstep. Okay. Right. So we like I said, we pre-measured, so.
Yeah, you can get, so you're going on that side to engage everybody.
Yeah.
Yeah, and got his 2 inches to misstep right there.
And, okay, now attacking misstep.
Yep.
First attack. Sorry, this is the first time playing him. Melee 6.
Mm-hmm.
So 1. I get I get misstep.
All right.
I get to flip 3 cards because of recall training.
Yeah, he has a built-in positive.
Awesomeness. I've got an 18 at the highest.
I've got 16 showing.
Would you like to cheat, Casey?
No. Are you living?
You leaving it is, actually, because of the guy riding him.
Yeah, so I have Terrify Living.
Okay, so I'll flip that right now.
Yeah.
Sorry, gotta pull him up. Yasunori? Oh, no, he is living.
Okay.
So he is willpower of 6.
All right, so go ahead and flip 2 for the recall training, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
He's good.
So, 6, yeah, 16, it's only 12.
Yes.
So I'm not cheating for defense.
I'm going to declare the trigger, wind and water.
All right, which and is, that's the ram? Ram yeah. And...
It's ram or masks.
Okay, so red, ram and masks.
And since this is the first time, I thought I would do a bit of explaining about Yasunori.
Yeah.
With his reading the wind, or wind and water, with the trigger, he would get to do an additional attack action.
Against the same target. Against the
same target.
And he can only use that once per turn, correct? Or activation? He can only
use that... After 16, take the da-da-da. This trigger may only be declared once per activation.
All right, so
only during his active or during once per his whole activation in the whole game.
Yep. So this is the one and only time he gets to use that. So yes. First we'll do damage.
So that would normally be a negative to a straight flip.
Right, with recall.
Yes. I'm going to cheat in a moderate. Oh, wait, that's moderate, right? Yeah, moderate. Okay.
Yeah, you flipped a moderate.
Okay.
I'll 6. All right, and that's, what, 3?
That's 4 damage.
4, okay.
So down to 3.
And then, yeah, take 3, so 4 taken. All right. So now here is the wind and water attack.
Yep. 1, 2, 3. Oh, sorry, I forgot to declare one of my schemes. Vendetta.
Okay. And you were 12 points, correct?
At
which that model?
Yeah.
It's 12, yeah.
Yeah. Alright, so I got a moderate with a crow.
Okay, so you have a 12 total.
Yeah, a 15 total, sorry, 15 total.
15?
Because I flipped 3 cards.
Oh, that's a 9.
Yeah.
It looked like a 6 from my angle. Okay. Hand like a foot. what are you at, 16?
No, 15.
15.
Yes.
So 15 to 10 is a negative to a straight. I'm not going to cheat.
Straight flip?
Yep.
I'm going to cheat in a moderate.
Yep. So
another 4 damage.
Another 3 for me. 3, 7. Chicken. All right. And you are declaring that trigger?
Yes.
Since you have it? All right.
Yeah.
So, second free attack.
1, 2, 3. 18.
So, 18 showing. I'm not going to cheat. I've got a... Or wait, hold on. I'm adding 5, 8. 8 to 18. So, that'll be straight flip.
Yeah.
All right, go ahead.
So, it's straight flip now? Or what was it?
Yeah, I'm at an 8 total.
And an 8 to my 18. Okay, yeah. So...
8 to 18 is 10. You need 11 to be a positive flip. So it's a straight flip.
Okay.
Or wait, sorry. It's a straight flip positive and...
Positive flip because of recall.
Recall makes it a positive. Yeah. There you go.
1, 2. Moderate of...
It's 4 again, so 3 more.
Yeah.
I have 10 wounds taken.
Mm-hmm.
Out of my 11... And okay. Burning 1. So, and here is your second AP, yes. Since those were triggers before.
All right. So 1, 2, 3. 19.
5. 14 to 19. That's right on a... Yeah. So negative up to positive. Or to a straight. Mm-hmm. Yeah. All right.
3 damage.
Right, 3. 2. And yeah, that will finish off misstep. Yep.
Okay. And that puts me up to 3 VPs because of...
Yes. Oh, we forgot last turn to calculate. So you're at 3 and I'm at 1.
Yes.
Both for Vendetta.
Yep.
All right.
And then it is now...
Yep. Is he going to use any other actions?
He's going to do his Great Sage.
All right, Great Sage, go ahead and...
Goes off. Okay. Top three cards.
Looking at those. Tell me when you're going to show the camera.
Yeah.
And I'll...
Right there. Okay.
All right.
And Yasunori's done.
All right, Yasunori is...
Hitting her.
I'm going to activate Hana. I'm going to use imbued energies to gain fast.
All right, three shots.
I'm going to take a shot at Jerry Gumo.
Okay, first shot.
First shot. So it looks like he is more than 1 inch from cover.
Yeah, he is, definitely. So, yeah. From eyeballing it.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm at a 15.
All right, 12.
Yes.
Well, you gotta go and do stuff.
I'm just a terrible person, Casey.
Yeah. All right, I'll go do 18.
Okay. Negative to double negative because of hard to wound.
Yep.
Can he ignore hard to kill?
No.
No. Okay.
All right. 1, 2. 3. Moderate of 3.
Okay, takes 3.
Okay. So.
Alright. That's
3. Second shot.
Like it. 11.
Alright. I will go to 14.
Alright, let me check. I'm gonna Joker to stop it.
Okay. And last AP?
Yep. Not cheating.
All right, I'm at a 10. So you're not cheating, you're at 7.
Yes.
All right, so that's 13.
Okay.
Which makes it a straight flip.
Yep.
And then a negative from Jerry Gumo.
Yes.
Hard to wound. All right. Puts
him hard to kill.
Yeah, puts him at 1 wound anyway.
Yeah.
Only 2.
Okay.
Right, why did I bother cheating when I was just going to hit anyway? Oh, 3 is more likely to call on the Black Joker. Yes.
Right.
Now, that had kneecap, but I'm not going to discard a card.
All right. So now my turn?
Yeah. Okay. So activating.
I'm going to activate the sound. I don't have any... Oh, I have one more scheme marker. He's going to drop a scheme marker. Right here. And then he's going to go over to... Then walk to the Jaragumo. Companion into the Jaragumo.
Mm-hmm.
And the Jaragumo is going to... Attack the hound. The hound's going to relent.
Oh, okay.
Okay. So I just go straight to damage. Was it triple negative?
Okay. So the hound is relenting, so you don't... I think technically for triggers and whatnot, you still flip one card.
Okay.
It's just that no matter what it is, you will hit.
Yeah.
All right.
I hit, and then...
And now, are there any triggers you need to declare?
No triggers.
Okay, so you count as having tied. Mm-hmm. The hound has nothing special defense-wise, so 3 cards.
1, 2, 3.
So you take the lowest.
So 3 damage.
So 3 damage, the hound is currently at 1 health.
Yeah. Then next,
so
then
I'm second attack, or...
Zero attack action?
Gonna use the 0 first.
Venomous bite.
So relenting, so you flip 1, and now damage.
So 1, 2, 3.
Alright, which is at least 1.
And I'm going to do Eat Your Fill.
Which ends his activation.
Yes.
Alright.
Back to 4. I forgot to put them all back.
Yep, and we can put it back now that he's done.
Yeah.
Alright.
Cute little bunny.
Yes, so activating the Jackalope.
Yep.
So charge 7, engagement 1. I'm going to charge this dudette.
Okay.
Charge the Witchling Stalker. And so Jackalope. Ready?
Yeah.
All right. Second attack.
All right.
That was better.
Defense 5, so 13.
13.
13, 15. So, would you like to cheat for it?
I'm good.
Okay, so negative flip for damage. All
right.
So, 3 damage to the Witchling Stalker.
All right.
Bloop.
Okay. Cool.
And, yeah, he's done.
All right, going to attempt to leap.
The rabbit is attempting to leap. So I need specifically a 5 of masks. Now there's one thing I need to
check.
So I'm going to cheat in a 7 of masks to make it work. And 7 only gets me there, but rather I'm going to leap to there.
All right. And done.
And the rabbit's done.
Okay. Then activate that hound. It's going to charge the orderly.
Yep.
He's in range. Yeah. Boom. The sword's 2-inch engagement. Or no, 1-inch. But he was in 1-inch right there for sure. Charging. First attack.
Is the sword only one? Or is it two? Well, anyways.
The sword's one, yeah.
Yes, that's the one with the sword. He's going after the orderly. Okay. Who's had an 18.
Okay, next one.
Okay.
15.
13. So, it's my potential time to cheat. I will not cheat.
I'm going to cheat in 8 with the ram's trigger.
Right.
Declaring crit strike 2. So the damage is...
It's got 2? Does it have 1 built in?
Yes, it has 1 built in.
Okay.
So what is...
All right. Negative flip.
Yep.
So 2 cards.
So that is 3 damage.
Okay. So 3 more damage. He's taken 4.
Yep. And he's got a nimble walk. Would you like to disengage?
Let's look up real quick one thing. The rules don't say that the Witchling Stalkers, the neutral ones, make disengaging strikes. So we're basically just going to assume they're so obsessed with getting to the child that they won't. Since there's no rules, so...
He's going to move his maximum.
So walk 6 back that way. All right. And that ends your activation, right?
Okay, Marcus?
I'm activating Marcus.
All right.
So I'm going to discard a tome to pick a second thing.
Okay.
So the 2 I'm picking are Strength of the Bear for +2 damage on Shillelagh.
Okay.
And Fury of the Tiger for a free melee attack action.
Okay.
Then he is going to charge the...
Yasunori?
Yasunori. He's got an 8-inch charge.
Okay.
Puts him to there. Yeah, first attack on Yasunori.
Okay. Pause the flip.
Right.
All right.
Defense. All right, so...
Second attack?
Yep, second attack.
Are you positive for this? Mm-hmm. I'm at a 14.
14. All right, so that's the charge. Here, I'm not cheating.
Okay.
Here is the free melee attack.
Okay. Flipping 2 cards. So 1, 2. I'm at a 13.
I'm at 18.
A 13. I'm not cheating, but I'm going to shuffle my deck while you're doing
your thing. Right. So
Yasunori took.
So that was a moderate, which for him is just 4.
4
same
damage.
As light.
All right.
And now the last regular AP. I'm going to attack Yasunori.
Okay. Positive. So 1. Yep. 2, 18.
Also 18. So that's a double negative.
Yep. Don't worry about 1, the black joker at least.
2, yep. Or the red. So again, 4 damage, so 3 more.
I love you guys to hear Casey's tone when he said the red, flipping for the most like non-beneficial thing.
three more damage.
So 3 more damage. Okay.
After modifiers. Now I just have to decide who I'm using my 0 on. Alright, so I'm going to use Drazi's Chant, targeting the boar here.
Okay.
So I need a 7 to cast it.
Sure.
7. So the boar has positive to its attack flips and double negative to its defense flips.
Alright.
And then I'm going to accomplice into the boar with Marcus.
Okay.
Alright, so you've recorded the damage, right?
Yeah.
So he's got 6 taken, 6 left, right?
Yes.
Alright, so...
So flipping for my defense, positive.
Yeah.
So 1, 2. All right, I'm at 16.
Positive?
Or sorry, 13.
13?
Yes.
All right, I'm at a 16 to hit. 16 with eat anything to heal.
You just heal from
the make a healing flip. 1, 2, 3.
Okay. Yeah. Let go.
Okay. So that's a negative flip.
Yep.
And let me just double check. Jazzy's chant should just be to hit. Plus on attack duels and damage flips. Actually, yes, it is and damage flips.
Okay.
Goes from a negative to a straight.
Okay.
So, all right, straight flip on the damage. 3 showing. That's 2 down to 1.
1 damage. Okay. Next deck.
Well, I'm going to take my healing flip. So that heals 2, which he only had 1 taken.
Okay.
All right, that was first attack, second attack.
All right. 17.
17, so no hit. Right, I don't hit, so nothing happens.
Okay.
Hold on, one other thing. Nope, okay. So he's done.
Okay. 10 Thunder Brother, activate. Right. He's going to do his Dance of the Heavens.
Mask, teleport.
So 3-inch place. I need my widget. Widget. Oh, Casey has my widget. You dirty thief. I'm going to go over yonder.
Hey, I'm sure you're responsible somehow.
I know. It's always my fault. 5 to here.
You've all been dirty cheaters in the past.
I know, right? For you, YouTube. Good at catching our mistakes. Moving 5 right to here, and then he's going to move another 5.
Yeah, I was almost pretty filthy myself.
Yeah.
With that tooth and claw, blade and claw. Moving 5
right to here. And then he's done.
All right. He does some fancering maneuvering to get over to that guy.
That guy over there.
Yep.
Casey's boar.
Activating this boar. So we measured everything.
Mm-hmm.
And just because of the way everything's blocked, right, activating this boar. So we were measuring, and just because of the way everything is, there are no legal charges.
Yes.
So he gets to act normally.
For once.
Well, yeah. I mean, we usually want him to charge anyway. Yeah. Let me double check. He should be walk 4. Let me just...
Oh, walk a 4.
Yeah, like charge 8, walk 4, you know?
Jeez.
If I'm just wandering around, it's, yeah, not... That's the other thing. You don't really want to walk them.
Yeah.
However, let me check if there's a casting. There is none. I'm going to use the 0 action, root around.
Mm-hmm.
Target a scheme marker within 4.
Mm-hmm.
Push this model into base contact with a target, then discard it.
Okay.
So push into base...
10 Thunder Breath?
What is his aura range?
5.
5? Yeah, definitely not. No, he's not.
Okay.
Yeah, but just worth checking. So no matter what, I push in, and then it is removed.
Yep.
And I have 1 AP left. I'm going to attack the dog.
Okay. Defense?
Yes, defense. So he has just a straight flip.
10.
15 showing.
Not cheating.
All right, so need to shuffle 4. Yep.
We'll get back to you guys. Okay, now Casey, we had to double check. He got the... He's declaring the healing flip trigger.
Yes, so we have... I got a crow, 10 of crows.
Yes.
So first damage flip, we have a negative on a... fresh, brand new deck. So that's 2 damage.
So 2 damage. Okay, putting the hound at 2.
And then here's my healing flip. 3, which heals him back to full.
Okay.
And that ends the boar, because that's all of his AP.
Okay.
So.
Okay, I'm going to activate Luna. Luna's going to... She has a beautiful walk of 6. So she's going to walk 6 to here. Boop. Then walk another 6 right behind this rock.
All right.
And she's done. He's activating his Blessed of December.
Yep, Blessed, the last thing.
All right.
Blessed is attempting to leap.
Okay. Oh, wait, no resistance for me.
Let me check, but I believe needs an 8. So, I'm not going to cheat.
Mm-hmm.
So, you don't have hard to wound.
No.
Just armor.
Yes.
All right, Blessed is going to focus and make an attack.
Okay.
So,
Oh, he gets positive?
Focus.
Oh, he's focusing. Duh. Yeah. Sorry. Focus. That's putting him at a 13.
So that puts me at a 16.
Not you.
Okay.
So negative to a straight.
Yeah, and my trigger doesn't work against you. Uh-huh. So right, negative flip to a straight flip. Three damage. So
three damage. So two. Okay. And the blessed's done?
Yeah, that ends the blessed's turn.
All right.
Okay, go ahead.
I'm going to activate Lucas McCabe. He's going to take back his upgrades from the hounds,
yep.
Which I didn't transfer over. Sorry.
yeah, we knew what happened.
We knew what was happening, yeah. He's going to walk. So seven to here. Seven to here. Then he's going to walk another seven right to here. And then for his one action, I'm going to do a black flash on the Jaraguma.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to burn a stone for a ram.
Yep.
I need a... sorry, one sec. I need a six of anything for this to go off. Goes off. He's going to gain reactivate.
Yep.
And then I'm going to do take this with my Jaraguma. I need a four of anything for this to go off. I'm going to cheat in a nine of tomes.
For the trigger.
And I'm declaring the trigger to give him...
And so what upgrade are you giving him?
I'm going to give him the Glowing Saber.
All right.
So Glowing Saber on Jaraguma.
And so do we, go ahead and do his push.
Yeah, nice. Push. And he has to be within six, so... Sorry, he's not fully on the base. Push him right to there.
Okay, just give him a little nudge.
Yeah, and then I'm going to do it again.
All right, start targeting the same?
Yeah. Can't do it. So, right. I need at least a four. I'm going to go three. All right, and then...
So...
That's all his actions.
Right.
Walk, black flash. And then
yep.
He's done.
Okay, and that is McCabe. Now, who are you doing next?
I'm going to activate the Jaraguma.
All right.
The Jaraguma is six. Positive. Okay. I'm gonna declare charge action with
him. Okay. Targeting the Witchling Stalker.
The Witchling Stalker, yeah. So he's going to move right about there.
He's gonna have to get a little closer, but
yeah. There we go.
Or hold on, okay. And yeah, after some finagling, we figured out exactly where Jaraguma needs to be.
Yep.
All right, and so he's charging. Okay, yeah.
Yep. All right, first attack. Because of promises, I got a positive. This is just, I'm going to be doing his, I don't like him saber. I should have gave him, dumb. I'll say later. I'm going to attack with his glaive. Melee 5.
Right. Defense 5. Yeah. At 11 at the moment.
Two.
Currently at 11 to 11. Your 9.
Yeah. No. Could do it again.
Yep. 17.
Freaking A, 10.
And what is the range on the bite? Is that also 3?
Yeah, it's 1. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to do his 0 to give him a 2-inch push.
Wander the Earth.
Yeah, Wander the Earth. And I'm going to...
Push. And there's no cast on that, right?
There's no cast. It just straight up happens.
Okay. Zero to Wander.
Widget, where are you? Oh, there you are, Widget. And then he's going to push. He was, like, right here.
Yeah.
And he's going to push to right to there.
Yep. Okay.
All right.
Go ahead.
All right. I'm going to activate this hound right here.
Uh-huh.
It's going to walk 6 here. And another 6 right to there.
All right.
Boom. And this hound, same thing. Walk 6 to here. Another 6 right to there. Bam.
All right. And last one over here. Are you going to attack or try to disengage?
I'll try to disengage.
Okay. So melee 5, you're what? Defense 5 or 6?
Defense 5.
Okay. So basically, you beat me by 1.
You cheat?
Nah, screw it.
Okay, he's going to move six. He's going to move another six. Call this the wolf pack.
Yeah. All right. And so that's the end of turn two, if you'll believe it, with the huge scrum. Steve's got most of his models on my side of the board, et cetera, et cetera.
I'm having a blast.
Oh, yeah, this is really fun. Yeah. All right, so I score one for having the child and one for killing one of the Witchling Stalkers. So that puts me at 3-3. So we're currently tied. This is turning out to be a very interesting game. Yeah. Looks like the kid is dead. All right, here's my hand going into turn three.
My hand. All right. Let's see. Flipping for initiative. 8.
Seize the day. 11.
11. All right.
Are you going to bother stoning?
I'm not going to stone.
All right. Again. Oh, so first things first. So we'll start with this guy. Or actually, so this one's not going to get rid of it. So yeah, we'll move him first, I guess.
Yeah, he's going to move.
So he's going to... The first one is 4. Won't leave your engagement. So let's do this right. it's going to go 1 inch. And then another 1. And then there, just be within 3 of you. Yep. Now the second one, you'll get a disengaging strike. Would you like to attempt to prevent disengaging?
Yes.
Okay.
Flipping. So positive flips because of... it's a melee action, right?
It is. Oh,
right. Because of promises.
Well, are you still in the aura?
Yeah. Oh, no, I'm out. Oh, no, I'm out. I'm out. I'm out. Okay. Yeah, you're right. So,
yeah, it's all good.
Okay, not cheating.
Okay, not going to bother cheating.
Yeah.
So moves 4 more to get towards the child. Now, here's the interesting one, and we'll move its damage dice. We've got 4 inches. Eek. Puts this guy engaged with the blessed. However, 4 more inches means he's still engaged with the blessed. And the child is removed.
Dang, dang, dang!
Yep. All right, now it's my choice. I'm definitely activating first. I just have to figure out what that action's going to be.
Yeah.
All right.
Okey-doke.
Okay, so Marcus will once more discard a tome to go into super melee mode, +2 damage and a free attack.
Okay.
I'm going to start with 1 attack on Yasunori.
Okay. I no longer get positive, so I'm just straight flipping right now.
Yep.
I'm at a 10.
I'm also at 10.
I would cheat first, right?
Yep. And this is my free for tiger style.
I'm going to cheat in a 6 to make it a 11.
So, Joe's beating me. All right, you're at 11.
Yes.
God, now I have to think about the things I need for other triggers.
Go on, pause.
No, okay. I've got it now. So I will cheat it up to a 12.
Okay.
So 12 versus 11, 1 negative flip.
Yep.
Managed to get severe, 6 damage.
Kill Yasunori.
All right.
Yasunori dies. He dies.
Yasunori. Corpse marker. Boop. One of the few Oni that do.
Oh, do you need corpses?
No, I don't actually. All right. So that is my first.
Mm-hmm.
Then I am going to... So Marcus is... Actually, am I engaged? All right. My engagement is pretty easy. I'm not engaged, so I'm going to charge him.
Okay.
Charge this one. Getting to there. So, first charge.
All right.
Attack.
Defense.
Yep. I'm at a 13 at the moment.
I'm at 13. All right. 13-8.
Which is a negative flip.
Which you get to a 17.
So you're at 17.
Yes.
So with 6, I need at least an 11. So I'm going to cheat it to an 18.
Okay.
So double, one negative flip. So 3 damage kills the
detonation.
Yep. You know what? It doesn't matter. Okay. So he's dead, and they'll both take the damage.
Yep.
So Blessed takes 1. Marcus takes 1. There, they both gain burning. busted. All right. Marcus has one regular AP left.
Yep.
All right. I'm going to start. Well, I'm going to use his zero action, Jawsy's Chant, on this boar.
Okay.
So, it's a three. Jawsy's Chant needs a seven. We'll throw in 10 to make it go off. The boar gains the positives and the negatives to its defense.
Okay.
One regular AP. He's just going to walk up to here.
Okay.
And he's going to use companion into this boar.
Okie doke.
The boar is going to charge. So I have to charge something.
Okay.
I'm going to charge the Witchling Stalker.
Cool.
I have 8 total inches. So basically going to do the whole thing where you go charge the other side.
All right.
Stay within one. All right, and here's my attack on the Witchling Stalker.
Defense?
That has 3 wounds. Yes. Positive.
17.
I'm at a 15 at the moment.
Did I cheat?
I will not cheat, so that misses.
Next attack.
So second attack.
11.
17 with the charge trigger.
Oh, what's his melee?
5.
And he's defense 5.
Yes. So a 12 will tie, a 13 will beat.
I'm gonna Joker.
Alright. Red Joker to miss. Boar has can't use a zero action. Boar is done.
Okay. So now my turn.
Alright, yep. You're activating him, Cabe, and he's getting the upgrades back.
Yep.
And you're figuring out what.
And then the 9 inches charge right to there.
Okay. Charging the Blessed?
Yes.
Alright.
And that's in range, yeah. So he's going to charge 9 right to there.
Yeah. Engagement 2, right?
Yeah, engagement 2.
Yep.
When he has the sword, he gets engagement 2. Which is really weird.
Really?
Yeah. Well, no, but his normal weapon has a 2-inch engagement, but when he gives it out, it becomes a 1-inch.
Okay, so attacks on the Blessed.
Positive flip because of promises.
That's right. It affects himself.
I'm at a 12.
Blessed is 6. I'm at a 14.
I'm going to cheat it into a 19, and I'm going to declare the hamstring trigger.
Okay, and that's what? Gives up slow? All right. So what? You're at 19?
Yes.
All right, 19 to 14. Standard negative flip. Okay. Go ahead. Negative flip.
Negative flip. All right. Moderates of 3.
So 3 more damage, and slow.
Yep.
All right, second attack for the charge.
Second attack, yep. 16.
18.
18. I'm going to attempt a companion into the stalk. Or first thing, before that, I'm going to spend my 30 AP on black flashing the...
What is the range on black flash? Like 6?
6 inches.
Okay, yeah. So one of the hounds, but not...
Yeah.
Dari Gumo.
I'm going to black flash that one.
The nearest hound?
Yeah.
Okay.
Actually, it's range 6. Yeah, I'll black flash
that one. The hound that's a little further back. Yeah. All right.
I'm going to stone for a ram.
All right, stone for the ram.
So I need 6 of anything. Cheated.
All right, 7 of rams. Okay. Yep.
And I'm going to take this with this hound.
All right, so not the one that's reactivated.
Not the one that's reactivated.
Okay, so the closer hound is getting an item.
Great, and I need a 4 of anything to do this.
All right.
Get it off. I'm going to give him the glowing saber.
All right.
And then I'm going to companion into that dog. Oh, sorry, 4-inch push.
Yep, dog gets a 4-inch push.
Push into base contact right here. Boom. And then I'm going to attack... the lady.
Yep.
Okay, first step. I'm going to get a 17.
So you're, right, the 11, you're at 17.
Yep. I'm declaring critical strike.
5, 12. 12 to 17 is a standard negative flip. All right, yeah, negative flip.
Negative flip. So that is 2 damage.
So 2 damage, there's 1 left on this lady. Out of 5 taken.
Next right. one.
Second attack for the hound.
14.
So you're at 14.
Yes.
Thinking. But yeah, I'll tie it at 14.
All right. I'm gonna declare crit check.
Yep. Or actually, hold on. You know what? I mean, you didn't discard the Black Joker. You still have it. I'm not going to cheat. You may as well just get the straight flip.
Okay, straight flip?
Yep.
Severe.
Yeah.
That kills it.
Yep. Explosive demise. Yeah, explosive demise on all 3.
Okay. So one on my hound. And burning one on my hound.
Yep.
All right. That's done, man.
Oh, yeah. He got that this turn. All right. Yep. Actually, let's go ahead and score. We each killed one Witchling Stalker.
Yeah.
So that brings us each up to 4 points.
Mm-hmm.
You want to go ahead and do yours? Or, yeah, there it is. I see the 4.
Puts
so,
me at 4.
Right, and that's your activation, so I'm up next.
He's activating this boar?
Yep, activating this boar. He's going to charge this 10 Thunder Brother.
Yeah, he can charge this other boar.
Yep. So, 8 inches.
Boom.
He might have to go a little more that way. We'll check. Well, we'll just put him there for sure.
All right.
Is in.
Alrighty.
Yep, alrighty, Pitey.
Defense.
Attack.
I'm at a 16.
I'm at an 18.
Not cheating.
Okay, nothing on a mask, so no triggers.
So negative flip?
Right, negative flip.
Okay. Oh.
So 2 damage.
That kills him.
Okay, that finishes him off.
Yeah. And eat your fill?
Actually, no, he's actually unwounded.
Okay.
However, I have a...
Oh, but you're already 2 charge AP.
It's a 0. I have a 0 action.
Oh, okay.
However, he's outside of that one, so he's going to target this scheme marker as the 0, push into base contact, and remove it.
All right.
And that ends his activation. All right. Jerry Gumo here.
Jerry Gumo, he's going to do his free 2-inch push. A 0.
Wander the earth, or a 0.
Push 2 right to there. And then he's going to attack the boar.
All right, attack that boar.
So you're at double negative for your defense, and I'm just
yep. So I'm flipping 3 and taking the lowest. So I'm at 7.
I'm at 14.
So can't cheat. That's a straight flip.
Straight flip. Of 3 damage, and I'm going to declare the entrap trigger.
All right.
Pushing base concept. So
boar takes 3.
Yeah.
He has 4 taken, so no cheating. All right.
And then another one?
Yep. 1, 2, 3. All right. I guess I red jokered that. 19.
19. Okay. He's done.
Okay. That was Jerry Gumo.
This is activating his bunny.
The murderous death rabbit. All right. So with a charge of 7, I'm going to go all obliquely like this to... engage.
Oh, 1 inch or 2 inch?
1 inch engage.
Oh, okay.
So it should just barely be in.
Yeah, you're good.
Okay, so bunny is going after Jari Gumo. Let me find the bunny. All right.
Melee of...
Melee 4.
Okay.
Your defense 5, right?
Yeah, 11.
Actually, now I have to decide. 11?
Yes.
You know what? Sure, I will cheat that to...
to a 13.
Okay. So negative, double negative because of hard.
1, 2, 3. So one up to two because it's from a charge. Two.
Okay.
Or, I mean, three. Three total.
Three. Okay.
Because he was at full, right?
Yeah.
So that's his first three. All right. So second attack from the Jackalope.
Okay.
I'm at 11.
I'm at 14.
14. Not going to cheat. Jackalope will, however... Yes, he will attempt a leap.
Okay.
I need a 5 of masks. So no masks, not cheating. Jackalope is done.
All right.
Okay, so activating him.
He's going to charge.
All right, going after the boar.
And then for sec.
All right.
Melee 5.
Defense 5.
12.
13.
13. Not cheating.
Okay.
Next tech. 18. Declaring critical strike.
All right, that hits with negative flip.
That is 2 damage.
All right. Chipping away. All right, that ends that hound.
Yep.
All right. Well, I've got one more.
Oh, okay.
I'm going to activate the Blessed of December.
Okay.
Blessed of December is going to attempt to leap.
All right.
All right. Fuck you, Blessed. It's all good.
Doesn't leap. All right.
McCabe's melee 6, right? McCabe's like 7 wounds.
Looks McCabe is 7 wounds, yes.
You know what, alright, he's engagement 2. I'm gonna walk to here, near the hound, and I'm going to make an attack on the hound.
You're slow.
Oh, that's right, use hamstring.
Yes.
Yeah, that's fine, I'll just move to there.
Okay. And he's done.
Yep.
So activating the reactivated hound.
Yep.
He's going to attack the boar.
Yep. And that's melee 5, right?
Yep.
So 10. 5 to 5.
One more time.
Yep.
18.
Okay. 18 to 11. Yep. So straight flip.
Straight flip. That's 1 damage.
Okay.
And he's done.
Activating Hans Hanna.
He's gonna fire at my Jarigumo.
Yep, gonna take a shot at Jarigumo.
That's 5. 13.
So shoot 6. So
15.
15.
So negative, double negative.
Hmm? Oh right. With Jarigumo makes it.
Yeah.
2. All right. What am I thinking? Right. 1, negative, 2 negative. So 2 damage.
So 2 damage. Okay. 2 more.
And so that's 5. He's got 3 left.
Yes.
All right. Yeah, second shot.
He's at 10.
All right. I'll cheat it up to a 12.
All right.
Anything to cheat?
No cheat.
So I need to shuffle because negatives.
Okay.
And I have 1 card left.
Well, you're going to do at least to my heart. Yeah, but you still have to flip a card. Yeah.
I have to flip them. Right. Yeah. All right, so this was the top card.
Oh, no damage. Oh.
1, 2, 3. Well, it's a good thing that happened at the end of the goddamn game.
All right, so no damage.
Yep.
So my turn.
Okay, go ahead.
This hound's going to double walk right to about to there.
Yep.
Out of your engagement. Okay. Move a little back. He had 12 inches to get to there.
Yeah.
Okay, he is done.
All right.
And then next I'm going to activate this hound. This hound is going to double walk right to about to here. And he'll be done. And then Luna, she has 7, so she's going to double walk right to here. And she's done.
Okay. And so, do you have anything to announce for scoring? I think we got it.
Yeah.
earlier, so no extra scoring. We're at 4-4.
Yep.
All right. Here's my hand for turn 4.
My hand.
All right. Initiative flip.
Yeah.
All right. So I've got a 13.
Yep.
I will take first turn. All of the Witchling Stalkers are dead, so you don't have to worry about them.
Yep.
All right.
Yep. Gonna activate Hans. He's gonna take a shot at Jarigumo.
Okay. Defense 5.
Shooting 6. So I'm at a 16.
Shot. I'm at a 15. Yeah, sorry, at a 10.
Okay.
What do you got again?
16. 18. All right. Cheat it to a 19.
Okay.
So,
okay. Negative. Double negative.
Negative to double negative. 1, 2, 3. So, 2 damage.
2 damage. Okay.
Brings him to 1. And second shot against Jarigumo. Cool.
15.
So, cheated up to a 16.
Okay. Let it go.
15 to 16. That's 3 cards again.
Yep.
1, 2, 3. All right. No black Joker.
Okay.
So, that kills the Vendetta target and killed with him, so that's 2 points.
Yep, but not by turn 4.
Vendetta doesn't have a turn.
Activating McCabe?
Yes. I'm activating McCabe. I'm going to, first thing, going to attack the Blessed.
And are you recalling your saber?
No, I'm not recalling my saber.
Okay, you're leaving that on the dog. Yep. All right.
First attack.
So, 6, 17.
Next attack. 13.
I'm at 11. You're at 13?
Yes.
You're going to have one more AP, potentially. Or, almost guaranteed. 13. 13. Right. Right, you're the same. I need to that to beat and that to tie. Sure, I'll throw out 14.
Next attack.
So last regular AP, right?
Yep.
Okay.
1, 2.
So
13.
Also 13, not cheating.
All right, this is when we flip the red Joker and kill her. 3 cards.
Yep.
Is she hard to kill?
Hard to wound. So
4 cards.
Yes.
1, 2, 3. Oh, 4. Oh, it's actually moderate.
And how much is moderate?
Moderate for McCabe. I was declaring crit strike.
Yeah.
That is 4 damage.
4. So 4, and yep, that does it. Actually, what's your minimum? Would have been 3?
My minimum would have been 3, yes.
Yeah, that would have done it too.
But I don't ignore it yet.
Don't ignore what?
The hard to... Does he have
hard just to hard to wound.
Oh, just hard to wound. Not okay, hard to kill. Okay.
So, yep, that finishes off the Blessed.
I'm going to do...
So you've got a 0 action, right?
Yeah. I'm going to take this with the... Oh, I want to keep you engaged. I'm going to take this with this dog.
All right, casting. Take this.
I need a... Sorry. I need 4 of anything. Comes off.
So.
Dang it, I made a mistake. Damn it. Alright, take this on this dog. I'm going to give it nimble. So give it a 3-inch push. Boom. Engaging you, though. And I'm going to accomplice...
I see. Yeah.
What's the spore at? He's almost dead.
He's taken 5. He's got 3 wounds left.
Engage with that boar. I am.
Okay. Mm-hmm. What do you mean?
From the stoke?
He has 1.
2. Oh, no, the sword. You're right.
Yeah.
Oh, I should have done that on the other guy. That was a big mistake. Okay, well, I'll do it on this dog then. I'll compensate this dog, and he's going to charge. Oh, he's melee too, right?
No, one.
One, okay.
So, charge, yeah.
Charge. And so, first attack.
Yep.
Positive flip.
Right.
18?
18.
Oh, right. Sorry, 17.
Why, six?
Because he's not melee. He doesn't have the sword. He's melee 5.
Oh, yes. Yeah. So, 18 to 17, I'm winning.
Not cheating.
Okay, so second attack.
Yep. I'm at a 15.
So you're at 15 to my 15 to 8. I will go up to 11.
Okay, so negative.
Yep.
That is one damage.
All right, he takes one more.
All right. And...
Okay.
Casey's activating.
Activating Marcus. I'm going to discard a tome. I'm going to give myself +3 walk and +2 damage with my shillelagh.
All right.
I'm going to shillelagh the hound in front of me.
Okay. Melee 6? Or, sorry, melee 6 for you or 5?
6.
6, okay. 5.
I'm at 14.
Cheated up to 9.
Okay, 14 to 9, negative flip.
Yep.
So, 1, 2, all right, 4 damage.
Oh, 4 damage even on min? Yeah. That's 3.
No, it's 2 plus 2.
Kills. His glowing saber goes back to
the cave.
Okay.
It's 1 AP. Okay, while I'm standing there, he is going to attempt to use Drazi's chant on him. So I need a 7. Alright, it's cast.
Okay.
Then, the walk of 8.
Can't I'm do going it. To... Oh no, wait, you get 2 walks. No, you can't remove it. Ha ha!
It's fine.
Okay, doke.
That's 2 and 0, so that's all 3 actions.
Okay.
Marcus is done. Okay, so activating that hound.
Yeah, he's going to charge.
Okay. You'll probably end up here, but yes.
Yeah. So, negative for you, Casey?
Yes, I currently have Drazi chant, so I'm still negative.
Yeah.
1, 2, 3, and of course, Red Joker, I'm at... Yeah, 19. But second attack.
Yep. There we go. Cool.
So I'm at 6.
I'm at 16.
All right. 6 to 16. I'm so it's a straight. Mm-hmm.
To an 8 with crit strike.
Okay. Minimum damage 3. 8 or to my. So you're.
Damage 2.
You're 2. 2. Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Right, so a single negative flip.
Yeah. 2 damage.
All right, and that is just enough to kill that wild boar. Oof. And I'm going to reveal frame for murder on the boar with the bullseye.
Okay. All right, now Marcus can go, and now McCabe can go kill.
All right, so one point? Boar. Yep, I score 1 for being killed on turn 4.
Actually, that was pretty ballsy, if you'll pause.
Activating the boar.
Yep, activating him. Take a swing at the dog. Hold on. The dog is... I'm going to focus and make an attack.
Okay.
So, all right. Wah, wah.
14?
You're at 14. The best I can... All right, boar's done then. Actually, so now I have to check if he can. I think, yeah, we said it wasn't in range last time either.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm so fucking dumb.
Going to hit the boar.
So I'm going to attack the boar.
First attack. 13.
I'm not cheating. And so I'm at 11.
Hello. Okay, so, negative.
Yep, neg flip.
Moderate damage, which for a dog is 3.
All right.
What's he at
now? Six. He's got two left.
Two left. Wow. All right. Next tech.
Why?
Oh, also why am I flipping two? Sorry.
Yeah, wrong dog. He's wrong not. Wrong dog,
sorry.
Okay, so I'm at 5, 14.
He's done.
Okay. And
Jackalope
is going to attempt to leap.
All right.
So no masks, which means it fails. I'm not going to cheat.
Could attack my dog.
So I'm just going to attack that dog.
All right. Defense. You hit.
So
11 to
17.
11 to 17, so that's by 6.
Straight flip.
Straight flip.
Oh, look, 1.
1 damage. All right.
Yep. Nope. Second attack.
All right. 15.
All right, so negative flip this time, because I was 16.
Yeah, yeah.
1, 2. Oh, look, 1 more one again. More.
Okay, so 2 damage on that dog.
Yep.
He's almost dead.
Halfway there.
All right, Luna.
Okay, activating Luna. I'm engaged with you. So first thing we'll do, 0 defensive bark.
Okay.
Discard a card to give her defensive.
Defensive 1.
And then we'll discard another card to give her defensive 2. So she's all defensive right. 3.
Spend 2 AP to do it again. All right.
Yeah. And done, man.
Yep, that's everything for both of us. So nothing that scores at end of turn.
Yep.
So we're going into turn 5 and possibly the last turn. Yes. Likely the last turn.
Here's my hand.
And here's my turn. My hand going into turn 5. I'm not 100% if we recorded that. This hound moved over here and dropped a scheme marker with his turn.
Boar?
Yeah, so activating this boar. I'm going to make an attack on that hound.
Defense 5.
Yep. Melee 5.
12.
I'm at a 16. Are you going to cheat?
Not cheating.
So you're at 12. Total. So... Okay, I will cheat in 8 of rams,
okay.
And that's a 13, so 1 negative twist. So 2 damage,
mm-hmm.
And then I make, that's the one that I take 1 damage.
Okay.
And I make a charge against the closest legal target, which is going to be this guy.
Oh, isn't the bunny?
Not closer. You're 5.5, the bunny's 6.
Oh, okay, all right.
So, since he's the closest target, I will charge...
That way?
To there.
Okay.
And now I'm attacking him.
Defense?
Yeah. Defense. So, melee 5.
8.
Why can't I think? 13. So, it's currently a negative twist. Minimum damage, 2.
Oh, let it go.
Okay. So, negative twist. So, 2 damage.
2 kills.
Finishes him off. I will use Eat Your Fill to heal.
Okie doke. And he is done.
And, yep.
All right. That's him.
Okay, go ahead.
Activating him. He dropped scheme marker. He's going to go right there. He's going to cast Black Flash on the Doog.
Now, yeah. Do you have what you need?
All right, let's see if it goes off. I need a 5 of rams, or a 6 of rams. Doesn't go off.
Okay, no rams. Okay, so that's
yeah,
McCabe.
Yeah, I thought of that initially, too. That's what, okay.
Yeah, so yeah, he puts himself where he's definitely within the foot of those two. All right, so McCabe moving there to place the second scheme marker.
Yep. And then he's going 0 sacrifice.
So he's going to dismount.
Yep.
And
about there.
Yeah. Pull him off for you. All right. So now McCabe's there. So it's my turn to activate.
Okay, Hans.
Yep. Oh, wow. I did not see that.
What?
Oh, Hans is walk of 3.
Oh.
That's less than Rasputina. That's pretty cray.
Well, there's some stuff with Walk of 2.
Really? 2?
I think so, yeah.
Well, the only thing I can think that's much less is, like, traps or shit.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Never mind. Holy hell.
Right. Casey's right, activating so Hans. We did some very finicky pre-measurements.
Yeah, so with the 3-inch walk there, he can just barely see.
It barely goes over his base. We had to bust out with the laser to be able to...
Yeah, it's very close. So I'm taking one walk mm-hmm. and then taking one shot at McCabe.
Right, defense 5.
Yep. Shoot 6. So I'm currently hitting with a 12. Would you like to cheat?
Yes. I'll cheat in a 5 to make it 15.
Or a 10 for 15.
Yeah,
got it. So 15 just for kicks and giggles. Cheated up to 15.
All right.
And then, what am I thinking?
3 cards.
So tied 1, 2, 3. So 2 damage to McCabe.
2 damage to McCabe. Gives down to 4.
4 left. Yes. And that's his activation for Hans.
Okay. Now mine?
Yep. You're up.
Okay.
I'm going to walk the hound 6. Right to here. And I'm going to drop a ski marker.
Okay. May have to move a little bit, but yeah.
Yeah. Here, I'm going to remove this one because it doesn't have a jackalope.
Yep. Jackalope, so nothing already in range, so I'm going to use leap.
Okay.
Meaning masks is a primary 5 of masks. Cheat in a 9 of masks.
Okay.
Jackalope will leap 7 to here.
All right.
And then charge McCabe.
Okie doke.
Pow.
Charge McCabe, all right. Defense 6.
Yep. Melee 5. Or 4.
13.
I'm at 14.
I'm going to cheat it up to 14.
So you're going to tie at 14?
Yes.
Okay.
Hoping for that Black Joker.
Yep.
Oh, are you going to cheat kiss?
That's what I'm deciding. Nah. All right. So 3 cards. 1, 2, 3. So minimum damage is 3.
Okay. That puts him at 1.
Okay.
Right.
Second attack.
13.
So I'm currently at whatever that is. 5. I'll go to 16.
Okay. Can't stop it. Oh, wait.
So a 10 would tie and 11 would beat.
A 1.
Okay. So positive flip. I'll flip 2 cards.
Yep.
No. So, cool. Yeah, it's like 4 damage.
Dead.
Blah. Okay. And that ends the jackalope.
All right. My turn?
Yep. Okay.
So discard a card, and then discard to do the 0 defensive, yep. And then discard another card to go 2 more defensive.
Yep. Same thing. So keep red defensive 3.
Yep.
Activate all her. Right.
So I'm going to activate Marcus.
Yep.
Marcus is going to give himself... Oh, so she's... I have to hit her twice that way, 3 times that way. So, actually, his buff doesn't actually matter, but it'll give himself +2 damage anyway.
Okay.
Then he is going to... Alright, he's going to use Alpha on Luna.
Okay, is that when you take over?
Yes, that's a 2 action to take over her action. So this is a willpower check. I need a mask to succeed.
Okay. 18.
20.
Would you like to cheat kiss?
Actually, I have no masks, so I do need to cheat. And I will cheat that to a 20 with the masks.
Okay, you win. Good game, man.
Yeah.
There's nothing I can do at this point.
Yeah, she's going to move out of range.
Yeah.
So you will score 2 points, and we're going to end 7-6.
Yep. Actually,
so finish your game. Oh my god, so close. By 1 point, which is...
Yeah, that came down really to the wire.
Yeah.
Yeah, and like you were sort of saying, the fact like you didn't have any face cards, it seemed like I had just enough to cheat,
My last two hands were really bad.
Yeah.
Really bad.
Because there are several moments if either of the...
The Jackalope missed.
The Jackalope missed. If either of them missed, mm-hmm. McKay would be alive.
Yeah.
You know, even if I used Luna to kill over the... Like, yeah. It relied on McKay. Taking out McKay was definitely...
Which, I mean... Key. We were talking about afterwards. Oh, maybe I shouldn't have not sacrificed McKay because... But I didn't know if this hound was going to be alive.
Right.
That's what I was thinking about. Like, if that... Because I thought Hans was going to shoot the hound to deny me trying to drop another scheme marker.
And if McCabe was still mounted, he might have. Because I would have known that, I can't really...
Yeah.
So yeah, it's a bunch of if but questions...
But activating that hound first and getting over there and dropping that scheme marker was...
Oh, that was key. Because yeah. I would have... That's a big part of what I would have gone after. Actually, you know, I might have activated... Okay, so what I had seen
mm-hmm.
was activate McCabe first.
Yeah.
So McCabe walks... Or McCabe places a scheme marker,
mm-hmm.
walks scheme marker, then a hound, then companion into a hound who drops one
mm-hmm.
nearby for him to count as.
Oh, yeah.
Something along those lines. I don't know exactly how it would have gone, but...
It would have been, oh yeah, that too.
But yeah, trying to keep those hounds alive.
All that was left was on the board. Was the boar? I was actually, I think I was a little overly cautious about. Oh well, I really, because I was worried about the boars going in and just starting with scheme markers, but they're so hard to control.
Yes,
you know,
there's a bunch of things that
can have go to wrong. Go right. Yeah.
That can go wrong.
But the Jackalope, such a good bottle for it. Was it 2 soul stones?
Yeah, he pays 2 soul stones.
And if he dies, oh, I have another beast that dies.
As long as one of my beasts dies, I get him back.
Yeah. What do you think of the Tooth and Claw, I think it's called?
You know, Misstep died pretty early.
Yeah.
So it didn't get a whole lot of use. But
well, I had
just that ability to mess around and have a zero action,
didn't we pretty much,
I like it.
We pretty much traded 12 soul stone models.
Pretty close, although...
Wait, 13. She's 13 as well, right?
Well, 12. They're both 12, right?
12 plus upgrade, though.
Yeah. Oh, yes.
Mine's 13.
The upgrade is plus 1.
Yeah.
Right. And I mean, yeah, you charged in and killed Misstep.
Yeah. I was really worried that you were going to put Misstep...
But it took me a lot more activations to kill, though.
Yeah.
So, sure, we traded points,
mm-hmm.
but...
Well, that's part of the
you
thing.
Traded a lot more
activations. Yasnor is scary. Like, you have to deal with her...
It's the same with Misstep.
Yeah.
Have to deal with them.
Yeah, because and the thing about it is like, well, I think they're both very similar in, just like I think Yasunori has that speed, that initial speed. While like Misstep, she has that nice.
Yeah, it's that initial charge, that 10-inch charge with flight is amazing.
12-inch,
but it's
range.
Not it's not as much utility as nimble.
Yeah.
So, yeah, it's. It's just, you get slightly
and
different
I,
things.
What was it? We went through half my deck. Or we went through 3/4 of the deck, I think, just with Yasunori.
Right.
Just,
you know, Yasunori and Misaki, they're the same kind of...
And recall training. Oh. Actually, I think Misaki's more deadly than Yasunori.
Well, yeah, but I'm saying it's the number of attacks and the number of cards.
Yeah.
Very similar.
Yeah. Just like once, and like, all he has to do is connect. That's why I think, like, as long as you connect with Yasunori... You should just be happy. And then, like, you get that trigger. And you're always going to get the trigger you want.
Well, okay. The first time, you always get one of them.
Yeah.
The second time, depending on you've recalled training or not and everything, you might not get it.
But
however, the thing is, you then have a
second
attack to try it, to fish for it.
So, yeah, you're more and more likely to get those 4 attacks.
It's a very good chance.
Also, I have to say, my hand was on fire for the first, I think, 2 or 3 turns.
Yeah.
No.
That's second turn is mine was really cold.
Yeah.
That's why I tried to play a little more defensive. I knew I just had to finish off Yasunori.
Yeah. Well, my first turn was actually very cold. But the thing about it is, like, having a cold hand in turn one isn't...
Yeah, it's
not
unless
you're playing a very hyper-aggressive master like myself.
Not always that big a deal.
Yeah, you'll be just fine. Turn 2 and 3, you want to try to get those stones. My second turn hand was pretty good, though. I got the Joker. And I was, as you guys can probably see from the video, I was holding on to the Black Joker the whole time. Well,
yep.
I mean, till...
I think turn 5...
Turn
was it 4?
I think it was turn...
No, not 3. It was 4 or 5 that
four
you discarded
five.
It.
Yeah. Because I was thinking, like, okay, it's at the point right now. Black Joker would just screw me, but I needed the cards. I wasn't...
Well, that's the point where even you're not flipping nearly as much. Your models are way down. Like, even McCabe giving stuff out, it's not nearly as vital as it was.
It's not as likely, early on. Yeah. I'm trying to think of anything else that's really key that happened. That Jarogumo. Oh, we also made a mistake with the Jarogumo. Mm-hmm. We forgot that it had slow. You gave it slow.
Yeah, we forgot slow on the first turn, and that on Eat Your Fill does not work on friendly models.
Yeah.
So it would not have been able to kill a friendly hound to do it.
Which is just like...
However, I don't... Specifically with the boars, they have a trigger eat anything that does work that way. Of course, you have to get the trigger.
It's not built in.
And no, it's not built in. Oh, okay. So you need a crow. And then after damaging...
The boars are really good in this mission, I have to say.
Yes, I saw this and I'm like, huh, from the Shadows melee unit would be super useful.
The
scheme
pool was
useful.
So counter to the
certain parts
strategy.
Of it where... Yeah.
I mean, like, oh, we have Breakthrough. I mean, Frame for Murder and Vendetta are usually pretty...
Right, those are pretty broad.
Yeah.
I mean, there's a good chance. There were actually... Twice on my Frame for Murder target, I flipped the red Joker for defense on a triple negative, and I'm just like, oh god. This is so bad in so many ways.
Oh,
like,
that's
you would have killed it on turn three and given me an extra point if I hadn't flipped a red
and
Joker.
See, and that's the thing about it, is like where it was in the game. It's really hard to score. They say, oh, you could score up to, what was it, 8 points?
8 points.
But... I mean, like, the child got knocked out really quick with the...
Yeah, I think we each scored, like, two or 3 points.
Casey, you thought initially that, oh, okay, if I kill the Witchling Stalkers, I get a point. No, it has to be on turn two.
Yeah.
Right.
Which is why I went a little easier on trying to kill them after that. Yeah.
I was, oh my god, also, I could have, if it wasn't for the Jarogumo. If the Jarogumo could have killed... The Witchling Stalker. I just needed to connect. I just needed to connect. Oh my god. But McCabe's awesome. I like him a lot. He's very... Just that versatility. And the upgrades are phenomenal. I want to try to get a Terracotta Warrior in this list. Because then I was looking at the point where we were in the game. I was like, man, I could use... You know, when McCabe is right here and I just want him to survive. I really want that potion.
Eternal elixir of life, of youth, or whatever. Yeah,
but then you probably would have just killed my Terracotta Warrior.
I mean, yeah, there's definitely the possibly punching it, but and I mean that's the thing is that if you just hey, I'm done with this one upgrade, I'm gonna swap out. If you do it in time, then it's done. You know, killing the Terracotta Warrior won't do a whole lot.
Yeah. But I mean, he's a pretty sturdy minion.
Yes and no, yeah.
Yeah.
He's armor and 4 wounds, but his ability to protect other things is priceless, you know?
Yeah.
Like, if he could have run up to Jarogumo and said, here's your protection.
And then just hide the
And now, well, he has to stay within, I think, 6, but as
no, long... 10.
Is it 10? Okay.
It's really long range.
But even then, even if he's just, you know, a little ways back... It means I have to kill him before bothering with Jarogumo.
Well, I mean, but you can just try to 1-2 punch it. But then 1-2 punching a Jarogumo is no easy feat.
I mean, it's pretty much clear out the Terracotta Warrior and then wait till next turn to deal with the Jarogumo because you have to do it all in one go.
Yeah. Well, because it's a, when you put the protection, it's a condition. And you remove the condition.
Oh, yeah. Well, I didn't have any offensive removal.
Yeah, no. But, like, if he... Like, I was thinking
But that's
more...
why the boars... Ah, wow. Even the boars, though, they'd only do one at a time to a Terracotta Warrior. So, yeah.
But it was a fun game. For week...
Definitely.
Week one. So now we gotta get ready for week two. For
Got some...
And so we have 10 Thunders lost. So yours becomes a Fire Mage.
Yeah.
And mine becomes a, what's it called?
Oh, basically, training with the Auron.
Training with the
Auron. So, yeah, we'll have to see what the final results are.
Yeah.
On that.
All right, well, I think we're ready to end it.
Seems good.
Talk to you guys later. Peace.
War.
Oh, my gosh.